At just 9 years old, Mosiah Bridge started his own company because he wanted to look and feel good about himself and earn some money along the way. As we honor upcoming Black History Month, Stephanie Scurlock shows us how this remarkable young man is sharing his success in making his mark in America.
The classic black and brown bow ties.
Those are the NBA prints. Some of the NBA prints and the MLK 50.
No longer rule the day.
I love, you know, different colors on one bow tie. Some of the African prints.
Memphis, Tennessee teenager Mosiah Bridges says it's all about expressing yourself through your neckwear.
That's my goal, to really have different prints and patterns that pop out at you that, you know, you can't make a decision at the checkout line.
Mosiah owns Mo's Bows Handcrafted Bow Ties, and at 19 years old, his business has already taken him around the world and back a few times. Former Presidents Obama and Bush headline his Wall of Fame, along with a dozen or so other famous people.
When we started out on this bow tie journey, I like to say, I was thinking, you know, Mo was nine, so I'm thinking lemonade stand at best.
We first met this sharp-dressed kid at 10 years old. He was cutting and sewing at the family dinner table like his grandmother taught him.
I just sewing something I never seen before. Something that speaks to me.
A trip to his elementary classroom revealed his bow tie vibe was catching on.
I'd send him to school with a bow tie. He'd come home with no bow tie. And what happened to your bow tie? I sold it. Oh, good. For a bag of chips. Or I traded it for rocks. So, but he at the same time, he saw the value in his product. So once it started making money, I think I said quickly, Mo could be my boss. and then that's what happened. At 9 years old, my boss was my son.
This savvy grade school entrepreneur landed on the Steve Harvey Show, then Shark Tank. He made the glossy pages of style magazines. At 13, the NBA even hired him as a fashion correspondent for Draft Day. 2 years later, he got a licensing deal with them.
It's been great to have so many mentors. Of course, I have Obama and Damon John. He's been a great mentor from Shark Tank, and I always say that he gives me great advice.
Mo realizes the importance mentors have played in his success, so that's why he and his mother plan to help other kidpreneurs reach their dreams.
They started Mo's Bows Foundation, where Mo and his mother help other children grow talents into businesses.
I thought, I've done it with Mo, and it's, you know, proven to be pretty good. So I just wanted to use the resources that we've made over the years and help and invest in other children.
Mo recently opened his first retail establishment.
You want to go with this?
Yeah, okay.
During the pandemic, he added swanky masks to his inventory, coordinating them with his bow ties. His goal? A clothing line and more retail shops.
I eventually want to have different stores around the world that different little boys like me can, of course, run and take care of. It's basically a thing where if we can't leave something behind, or if we can't help someone else achieve what I have achieved, then there's no point in this at all.
Mo's Bows keeps growing, and so do Mo's dreams, not just for himself, but for others. In Memphis, Stephanie Scurlock reporting.
Wonderful story there. We are honoring Black History Month through February. For more stories, go to the feature section of fox2now.com.